Have you heard about rivalry between Ford and Ferrari? If not, then today's video is going to be very, very exciting for you. Just a month ago, I watched this movie called as Ford Vs Ferrari. There is also a documentary available on this online. You can watch after watching this video. And this particular story is story about leadership. There are a lot of lessons which we are going to learn about leadership, at least five lessons you are going to take away from this video. But this whole story is very, very interesting. So I would recommend watch this video till the end and you are going to learn at least five things out of this video. So if you're excited, then let's get started. This was the year 1960, and this is when Henry Ford II realized that his company has more of a brand image of a family car maker. And in 1960s, baby boomer generation were looking for more of a good-looking, sporty, and classy kind of a car. So he reached out to his leadership and asked them, how can he change his brand image? Now, senior leadership told him that making a sports car is not cup of tea of Ford Motor Company at that point of time. So the good idea would be to buy a company which is making sports car. And this is when they reached out to Ferrari. Enzo Ferrari was the owner of Ferrari and he was in a deep debt at that point of time. And they started discussing about the deal. And everything was going fine. And this is when Enzo Ferrari got to know, as a part of merger and acquisition, he's also going to lose control over his Ferrari racing team. And he became very, very angry. And what he said was, go back and tell your boss, basically Henry Ford, too, that he makes the ugly car in ugly looking factory. He literally insulted. And then he sold his company to Fiat. So the first key lesson from this story is, don't complicate the process of merger and acquisition. If you really think what was the objective of Ford Motor Company, they wanted to buy a company which was into sports car making and that would have become their another arm. But instead of that, they focused on the Ferrari racing team and this is where they lost the deal. So for you, also the lesson is, what is your prime objective? When you are into a deal, what is your prime objective? Don't get stuck because of some clause which has no meaning. So don't complicate the process of merger and acquisition. Lesson number two is, don't insult your competitor. So Ferrari insulted Ford, and cutting the long story short, actually Ford was able to build a sports car and they were able to beat Ferrari in one of the most prestigious race in which Ferrari was winner from a very long time, which is called as the Le Mans. So don't insult your competitor, because if you hurt somebody's ego, you don't know till what extreme that competitor is going to go. And as you know, Newton's third law, right? Every action has got equal and opposite reaction. And Ford actually consecutively has beaten Ferrari 4 or 5 times after that in the Le Mans race. So lesson number two, don't insult your competitor. Lesson number three is, outsource and partner. So what Ford did was, he hired somebody named Carroll Shelby, who was the only American who had won Le Mans race, and he outsourced this project to him for building a sports car. And Carroll Shelby hired somebody named Ken Miles, who was one of the finest mechanical engineers of that particular time in US. And this is a very, very funny scene from the movie where Carol Shelby is discussing with the Ken Miles that Ford Motor Company wants to build a sports car, and Ken Miles can't believe that it is something which is possible, and says, how much time they have given you? 200-300 years? And then he says, no, 90 days. So Ken Miles is somebody who does not believe that it is something which is possible, but because of the leadership and because of the vision of Carol Shelby, he agrees that he is going to help him in building that car. And what they did was, there was a sports car which is into development, which was called GT40, and they partnered with that design team, and with their help they started developing. So when you want to know more about the story, I would want you to watch that documentary or that movie. I am not going to spoil the story, so we are only going to take the lesson from the movie, right? Outsource and partner. That's a lesson number three. Lesson number four is, what happened was, in 1965 Le Mans race, they dropped Ken Miles, who was actually the chief of the entire driving team. So they actually dropped him, saying that he has an attitude issue. And in 1965, actually Ford lost the Le Mans race. And Carol Shelby was called in Mr. Ford's office to explain the reason why did the Ford team lose this particular match. And what Shelby saw within the Ford company, that there was just one file, and in order to reach that file to Henry Ford's hand, there were 17-18 people through them that file had to pass, which is called as a red file. And so he realized that there is a hidden factory inside, and then he reached out to him. When Henry Ford asked him that, why did we lose, he said, committees don't win race. What it means is, he was not having a direct communication with Henry Ford, and between him and Henry Ford there were multiple people who were making decisions. And after that, Henry Ford says that here onwards you are just going to report. So just check, do you have a hidden committee within your company where key projects are getting delayed, right? So the key team players who are playing the game of your company, who are in the race, they should be in direct connection with the senior leadership rather than having a hidden committee in between, right? So committees don't win race, team wins race. The fifth lesson is, spectators don't know the game. So this particular scene, what happens is, Henry Ford II is again somebody who is thinking of dropping Ken Miles because of the attitude issue. And Carol Shelby takes him inside the racing car and shows him what it takes to race. And when he goes through that kind of a speed, he realizes that what is this game all about, and then he accepts the Ken Miles for the game. So again, Ken Miles was able to win game for them, 1966, and there are a lot of drama in the movie. I would say one of the finest movie I have seen this year, Ford vs Ferrari. Lot of lessons for entrepreneurs. I mean, I am just covering these five, but there are so many lessons for entrepreneurs. Ken Miles, this is the actual picture of Ken Miles. He was included in Motorsports Hall of Fame of America in year 2001. So go check out this story in detail. I am making you more curious. And go check out this story, check out this movie, check out this documentary. There is a lot to learn from this. So hope these five lessons on leadership will help you tune your team, tune your company, and tune yourself. So this is all I wanted to talk to you today. Tomorrow I will come back with another video. Till then, goodbye.